You've probably noticed that there are things you can do on your own and things that are impossible to do. But there are also certain things in kind of a middle zone that you can't do on your own quite yet, but you can accomplish with a little bit of help. And that help might be from a teacher, from a parent or guardian, or from a peer. But it might also be a resource like a book, a video, or a podcast. This is true not only of gaining new skills, but also learning new information or understanding new concepts. In 1962, the Russian psychologist Lev Vygotsky called this space the Zone of Proximal Development, or ZPD. He developed this idea as a criticism of psychometric testing in education, which viewed intelligence as permanent and fixed. Now, here's how ZPD works. At the center, you have the things that you can do on your own. On the outside, you have the things that you cannot do on your own. But in this middle zone, you have the zone of proximal development, which are the things that you can do with guidance and support. In 1976, Jerome Bruner applied Vygotsky's theory to the educational setting with the concept of scaffolding. Here, educators provide supports, called scaffolds, to help students master the learning. Then, like the scaffolds in a building, teachers pull back the scaffolds as students master the knowledge and the supports become unnecessary. At this point, the ZPD grows outwards as students master new knowledge with new scaffolds. Now, with scaffolds, you tap into prior knowledge and build on it with key supports. These might be tutorials and videos or visual aids. They might also involve using sentence stems or front-loading vocabulary for language. You might provide leveled reading, graphic organizers, or additional think time. Or it might mean breaking down directions into smaller tasks. Scaffolding can be challenging. It takes time and energy, which is a struggle with large class sizes. But when it works, it can lead to better learning and deeper thinking.